سام سبعاني اوريجينالي برسين رفيجي فروم جوردان بات اي واز بيرن اند ليفت اول ماي لايف ان سيريا ان اني اون بوك So Jafra is a youth-based organization. That means we work mainly to empower young people to take responsibility and make decisions. We established in 2002 in Yarmouk camp, and now we work in six locations after the war beginning in Syria, in six Palestinian camps, and there we do our best to reach the people who need us. So we don't work according only to help the Palestinian, but also to help whoever there and need help. So a lot of Syrian IDPs and a lot of refugees. Mainly in these locations, what we do is the help of around 500 to 600 volunteers. In the besieged area and hard-to-reach area, we do also services like water trucking, waste management, and relief activity. In the same time, we try to invest and empower the self-sufficient resources inside these areas. So how to make diesel out of plastic, how to make from the ground food, how to raise more animals in the community so also people could have resources in case there is besiegement, and also have job opportunities. So
this shows you on the whole Syria and where we are. And then in each government, like Damascus, for example, we are in five locations in Damascus. And here is the Palestinian camps all around Damascus. In this, we see that the Palestinian camps, most near of them to the city of Damascus, is Yarmouk camp. This is why it is important, because it's part of the city. Khan Sheikh camp, which is part on the highway between Quneitra and Damascus, and this is also why it is important. Khan Sheikh camp
is a camp that has a case which is mostly to protect the camp by the civilian power. So always insist that it is a civilian camp and all civilian activity should continue. It's a Palestinian camp which contains around 12,000 civilians. In this video, we show the activity we did with the whole community to demonstrate against the shelling and to ask for a safe environment in the camp. Unfortunately, lately there was targeting for this civil key bombs. Like our center was bombed, the hospital was bombed, the school was bombed, the vegetable market was bombed, and this was make us more worried about the future of this camp. Because for us, it's a Palestinian refugee camp. It's the most near camp to the Palestinian border. And it's a witness of the Palestinian refugee problem. Our main job in the community is to protect our community from extremism. We do this by giving the chance for other young people and children to have the education and to have a little bit of work opportunity. This video shows our education program in different areas in Syria. Mainly we do this because in areas where education stops, these children have no other solution to go and study or to do something except in other extremist schools. And we try to let them avoid to go there and give them the chance to have a good education that will not also affect on their minds and change their future. If you go to fight now, what you will do in the future? Why you will lose your life for fighting with anybody? How we can make ourselves more strong against extremism ideas? And mainly we fight ideas. Nusra or Qaeda or IS or whatever extremist cannot enter our community if the idea is not accepted and if the idea is not needed. So we cover the need, we try with everybody else to cover the need and fight the idea. IS cannot enter our community if they don't do anything. If you do everything in this community, how they will enter to the community? If you have a school, why they will open another school? Nobody will go to their school. No mother will send their children to IS school. If there is another school, nobody wants to die if he has another choice to live. But there's no choices for life.